way you live up, when we obey that instruction, seek the kingdom first, every other thing people are working for, they will be added up to us in Jesus' name. I said they will be added up to us in the name of Jesus. That will be our testimony. I have told people, and I keep saying, that I will own houses, I will show houses, but it will never come out of my pocket. God will just give them to me. And that will be your testimony. And that will be the testimony of this ministry.
Amen.
Houses, cars, jobs, we will give it out free of charge. Because God will bring it. All he wants us to do is to begin to dream for his kingdom, is to begin to live for his kingdom, is to begin to make the kingdom move us. Let the kingdom be your motivation for doing anything you are doing. I'm a child of God and I love my God. You are doing it out of love, not so that people will see you and applaud you. As a matter of fact, let me say this thing. No matter what anybody does here, your name will never be mentioned. Nobody is going to give you any special thank you. Are you understanding me?
Yes.
Because we are doing it out of love, not for any man to thank us, but for God to bless us. And Jesus said, your Father that sees everything will publicly reward you. People don't understand. So they do the little thing and they're expecting the church to call them and specially thank them. Jesus said, you have received your reward already. Now, that's not the reward I want. I don't need your thank you for anything. Your thank you will change one thing in my life. But when the blessings started falling on me, everything changed. The blessings of God will fall on you in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Are you understanding? And so God is going to bless you because you are now dreaming about his kingdom. Some of you are going to write checks in millions for the kingdom.
Amen.
For
God
and your family ministry.
Amen.
And you do that in humility out of love for God without expecting anyone to call you and say, Mr. A, Sister B, we thank you so much. We saw the check. God forbid that will not happen here. Because we don't want to stand in the way of your blessing.
Amen.
The moment we do that, you have received the reward already. Now, is that what you want?
No.
No. Yeah. So you see, people don't get it. Some people even pay tithe and they expect special thanksgiving. And because they didn't call them to tell them, I'm not paying it again. You see, they are ungrateful people. You know the tithe I paid last month? You know the tithe? And he will sound as if he paid 10 million. You know the tithe? You say, how much? $500. Can you imagine that? 500? 500. That somebody used to buy a shoe from JCPenney. And he gave it in the house of God and he thinks he must be specially thanked. Say, thank you, Jesus, for light.
Thank you, Jesus, for light.
You do it in humility and out of love for God. Out of love for God. Praise the Lord. And so become a kingdom dreamer. Church, every one of us here is a kingdom dreamer. From today, listen to me, church, from today, let the house of God be your dream.
Amen.
Let everything we are doing be your dream.
Yes.
Go before God because of the house of God. Labor in prayer because of the house of God. Travail until you see, Father, we need a sanctuary. And then that moves you into prayer and fasting without anybody telling you. And you dedicate yourself, Lord, show me. Father, where is the place? I know you have a place. Lord, like David, I am not eating today until you give us this breakthrough. Nobody will know you did it. But when God answers your prayer and his church is blessed with that, oh, you go to God and ask him, God, who am I? Then you are so mindful of me.
Amen.
Who am I? And God is saying, you have forgotten the seeds you were sowing. How many of you know prayer is a seed we sow? Prayer for the kingdom is a seed you are sowing. But people don't know. You know, because a lot of pastors have brainwashed people into thinking that when we are talking of seed, it's just cash. You understand? Yes, money is part of it. But we have a whole lot of seeds you sow. And listening to this, Anytime you are thinking of a tree, think of a seed. I hope you understand that. Anytime you are thinking of a tree, think of a seed. A tree is nothing but the future of a seed. That's all. So you want to become the tree that will bring forth fruit, then let your seed go to the ground. That's all. The origin of every tree is the seed. And God willing, from next week, we are going to be talking about seed. We are going to be talking about seed. We are going to be talking about seed. For you to know the difference between the rich and the poor. It's not the work they do. It's not the school they go. But the difference between the rich and the poor is in what they eat. Glory be to Jesus. I know somebody is thinking, yeah, the poor eat poor food and the rich eat rich. That's not what we're talking about. But God willing, next week, the Spirit of God is going to take us into it, and you understand the importance of seed. The importance of seed in every area of your life. And every one of us here is going to become a mighty tree, bearing thousands upon thousands upon thousands of fruit to the glory of God. In the mighty name of Jesus. Shall we stand up to our feet?
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you. Lift up your hands unto Him. Father, make me a kingdom dreamer. Lord, I need the heart that David had. Father, I need that heart. I need that heart. Lord, from today, all my dreams, Lord, is going to be a kingdom dreamer. From the beginning of this year, I made a vow to you, Lord, that this year I will walk with you. This year I will live for you. Father, in the name of Jesus, I receive the grace to be a kingdom dreamer. I receive the grace, Lord, to be a kingdom dreamer. I receive the grace to live for your kingdom. I want only your kingdom to move me. I want things in your kingdom to move me. Lord, the grace to sow my life as a seed in your kingdom. The grace to sow my life as a seed in your kingdom. Please bring that for me, your phone. The grace to sow my life as a seed in your kingdom. Lord, I receive that grace.